Thanks for being with us in prayer today. I'm Father Ron Hoy, and this is the God Minute. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Lord, open my lips,
and my mouth shall declare your praise.
Psalm 9. Lift my spirits that I may be of use. I give thanks with my whole heart for every rock of the earth, every star of the sky. I will rejoice in you and be glad, and sing psalms to your name, O Most High.
I praise you for your presence in my heart, O God, which makes me strong and unafraid. You are a refuge for the oppressed and troubled. Those who put their trust in you are comforted.
Whisper in my heart, O God, for I am tormented by difficulties and discouraged by the awful state of the world.
Lift my spirits so that I may be of use, and trap the wicked with the works of their own hands. Help me to set things right so that the needy are not forgotten and the poor have hope.
For we were created in your image, and our life should be a blessing to us all.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Do not be led away by diverse and strange teachings, for it is good for the heart to be strengthened by grace, not by foods which have not benefited those devoted to them. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh man, I love that first line of Paul's reading today. Do not be led away by diverse and strange teachings. I gotta say, whenever I hear that, I think back on when I was first ordained a priest in 1991, I went to a parish in southern Missouri where there is a big Baptist country. And so RCIA, the program in the Catholic Church that helps unbelievers believe and become Catholic, was something that I was a part of and just absolutely loved. Well, I was so amazed at the kinds of questions that these people asked. I remember one was talking about how Catholics worship snakes. Or the Blessed Mother, she was always a big question getter. People saying that they heard Catholics worship Mary as a god, higher than Jesus himself. Is that true? Or another was that priests belonged to this secret cult that the Pope was in charge of, whose mission was to make everyone Catholic, bring everyone into the church so that we could take their money and their firstborn sons to become more priests in this evil cult. Wow. But it's not just Baptists. As I moved into my priesthood and talked with more and more Catholics, the more I came to see that as Catholics, there's a lot of disinformation out there. Catholics, raised Catholics, who were taught and told various things that are just absolutely not true at all in the Catholic Church, but we just assume that they are. You know, things like Catholics reject the theory of evolution and are opposed to all things scientific. Not true. That what the Pope teaches, we must believe. Oh, not true. You know, what else? Oh, the Catholics don't believe in the Bible. They discourage it. Absolutely not true. You know, if you get a divorce, that's a mortal sin. That's not true. A lot of stuff that we hear about, that we read from wherever. But here's something that is true, in which we're reminded today by Paul in sacred scripture, that to be a responsible Catholic is to be an informed one. To make time in our days to read scripture, to get a book that leads us spiritually on journeys, to help us appreciate more what it is that we say that we do believe. Go to conferences. You know, I think part of the challenge is that for many of us, especially cradle Catholics, those who have been born into the faith, is we went through school way back when with all those nuns and have all kinds of scars to prove it. But after we graduated, we haven't done anything or very little more to advance our faith, our learning, our understanding and appreciation of it. So folks, I urge you today, as I do myself, to do something about that. To pick up a good spiritual book and start reading, to open up the Bible. I'm reminded in Scripture that Jesus, he never wanted blind followers. He wanted people who listened, who took in his word, who reflected upon them, so that they could make a commitment for and to the kingdom. And as Paul reminds us today, that's what it means to be a follower of Jesus. Let us collect our hearts and our voices and pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Let us pray. Father, your love never fails. Hear our prayer. Keep us from danger this day and provide for all our needs. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Blessings upon you, my friends. Thanks for being with us. We'll see you tomorrow.